السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So in our previous session we discussed what do we say when we woke up, when we wake up from the bed, from the sleep. What do we recite the dhikr?
بسم الله الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور.
Yes. بسم الله in the name of Allah. الحمد لله praise be to Allah. الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا who made us alive after our death. That is after sleep we are awakened. Okay. وإليه النشور and to him is our resurrection or return. بعث. Okay. Now in another hadith we see Sahih al-Bukhari hadith number 183 reciting of the last 10 verses of Surah Al-Imran. Surah Al-Imran is recommended. It is sunnah. That is starting from إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ لَآيَاتِ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. From that verse onwards to the end of the surah. That hadith we see. Kitab al-Wudu, Sahih al-Bukhari, under that Kitab al-Wudu, Book of Ablution, Ablution, Wudu, Wudu, taking Wudu for Salah and all. Under that Kitab, Bab Qira'ati al-Qur'an ba'd al-Hadith wa ghayrih. The recitation of Qur'an. Or doing other invocations, dhikr, etc. After hadath, hadath means the state of being impure. Two types of hadath are there. One is hadathul asghar, that is the state of not having, yes, wudu, allowed. Yes, no, state of not having wudu. Now hadathul akbar means that is after sexual intercourse and such that is after the stoppage of menses. And nifas, that is, then one has to take a bath. Okay, so that state is called before taking the bath. That state is called hadathul akbar. Hadathul akbar. Come, so the state of impurity is of two types: hadathul asghar and hadathul akbar. So hadathuna Ismail. قال حدثني مالك عن مخرمة ابن سليمان عن كريب مولى ابن عباس أن عبد الله بن عباس أخبره أنه بات ليلة عند ميمونة زوج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهي خالته فالتجالد في أرض الوسادة والتجع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أهله في طولها فنام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى انتصف الليل أو قبله بقليل أو بعده بقليل استيقظ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فجلس يمسح النوم عن وجهه بيده ثم قرأ العشر الآيات الخواتم من سورة آل عمران ثم قام إلى شن معلقة فتوضأ منها فأحسن وضوءه ثم قام يصلي قال ابن عباس فقمت فصنعت مثل ما صنع ثم ذهبت فقمت إلى جنبه فوضع يده اليمنى على رأسي وأخذ بأذن اليمنى يفتلها فصلى ركعتين ثم ركعتين ثم ركعتين ثم ركعتين ثم ركعتين ثم ركعتين ثم أوتر ثم اضطجع حتى أعطاه المؤذن فقام فصلى ركعتين خفيفتين ثم خرج فصلى الصبح And Quraib, Quraib reports this hadith. Mawla ibn Abbas, he was the slave of ibn Abbas. Yes. Anna Abdullah ibn Abbas akhbarahu. Ibn Abbas informed him. That is Quraib. Annahu, suddenly he baata laylatan. Suddenly he stayed overnight. One day he stayed.
Overnight.
One day, one night. He stayed. where عند ميمونة زوج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عند ميمونة near or in the house of ميمونة رضي الله عنها who was ميمونة رضي الله عنها زوج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم the wife of the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم وهي خالته and she was the خالت of maternal uncle no no aunt of ابن عباس رضي الله عنه his mother's sister okay his mother's sister and the wife of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم فالتجعلت في أرض الوسادة and during that night I that is ابن عباس رضي الله عنه who laid horizontally or transversely in the bed and واتجع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأهله في طولها and the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم and his wife ميمونة رضي الله عنها laid in the bed lengthwise allowed yes then فنا so the house was very small their house prophet's house his wife's house were very very small okay then no much facilities were there okay very very simple house then فنام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى انتصف حتى اذا انتصف الليل then prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم slept till the midnight till the middle of the night okay او قبله بقليل او بعده بقليل a bit before that or a bit before after that is the approximate time midnight okay then استيقظ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم then رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم woke up from the sleep yes from the bed then from the sleep then what happened then فجلس رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يمسح فجلس يمسح النوم then he wiped out the traces of the signs of نوم sleep from his face with his hands okay then عن وجهه بيده ثم قرأ العشر الآيات الخواتم من سورة آل عمران then he recited 10 verses the last 10 verses of سورة آل عمران okay ثم قام إلى شن معلقة then he stood up and went to a vessel a water skin which was hanging which was kept hanging there was water in it okay فتوضا منها and he took wudu ablution from it فاحسن وضوءه and it was a perfect ablution it was a perfect wudu there then ثم قام يصلي you know the Arabic portion Arabic then Arabic hadith Arabic then ثم قام يصلي then he started offering صلاة التهجد صلاة الليل okay قال ابن عباس then ابن عباس continues his description ثم ذهبت then I also went فقمت إلى جنبي then I stood by his side he stood actually ابن عباس first stood in the left side prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was offering salah then didn't learn me look then fa wala yadahu al yumna then prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put his caught his fa wala yadahu al yumna that is put his right hand prophet's right hand ila فوالا يده اليمنى على رأسي upon my head that is ابن عباس رضي الله عنه's head وأخذ بأذني اليمنى then he caught my right ear then يفتلها and he caught it then فصلى then he made me to stand in the right side to stand in the right side so standing when imam One imam and only one ma'moom is there. Then that ma'moom should stand in the right side of the Imam, not in the left side. So Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu unknowingly stood in the left side. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam caught him and made him stand in the right side. Okay. فصلى ركعتين. Then he offered two rak'ah prayer. Two rak'ah salah. Then ثم ركعتين. Then two rak'ah. 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 So all together 6 into 2.
12
rak'ah salah. ثم أوتر. Then he performed witr. This witr, whether it was single rak'ah or three rak'ah, there is khilaf. There are discussion. So, summa taja'ah, then he laid on the bed again. Summa hatta ata'ul mu'adhin, till the mu'adhin, the person who calls adhan, is called adhan. Adhan is called mu'adhin. Mu'adhin in Arabic, mu'adhin. That is, the person who calls adhan or call for prayer is called muadhin. Muadhin. Then till the muadhin came to inform him that the time of salah is ready. The time of salah is there. Okay. Then faqama. Then he stood up again. So salla rak'atayn khafifatayn. Then he offered two light rak'ah of the sunnah of sunnah or rawatib sunnah just before subh. Then summa kharaja, then he got out out of the house. Fasalla rak'atayn fasalla subha. Then he offered salah with the offered salah in the masjid as subh. Offered salah to subh in the masjid as imam to the people. Okay. Now we shall see the verses of Surah Ali Imran. Just we shall see the verses and the translation in English. So these verses you should learn by heart. Even if you don't learn it by heart, you may recite it after taking wudu, then take your mushaf, then after waking up from the sleep. First we say, Bismillah alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. Then we go and wash our hands 3 times. Then take after miswak, take wudu, then with mushaf, looking into mushaf, you can read. Okay. So if you learn it by heart, you can read it without wudu also. Okay. That's why the this hadith is given under this bab, that is reciting Quran and dhikr etc. In a state of hadas, that is in a state of not having wudu. Okay. The verses.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار ربنا إنك من تدخل النار فقد أخزيته وما للظالمين من أنصار ربنا إننا سمعنا منادي ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد.
إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Certainly, indeed, in the creation of the earth and the heavens. Inna, certainly, fi khalqis samawati wal ard. Samawat means heavens. Ard means earth. So, in khalq means creation. Inna fi khalqis samawati wal ard. Certainly, in the creation of the heavens and the earth. Wakhtilafil layli wal nahar. And the alteration or changes. In that night and the day. So, day and night comes one after another. Okay. And in those things, لآياتٍ. Certainly there are signs. لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. For those who understand. Or for the men of understanding. There are signs. That is, certainly in the creation of the heavens and the earth and in the alteration of day or changes of day and night. In all these things, there are signs for those people who understand things. Okay? So, when we brood over or think, give thoughts of these things, these natural things made by Allah, created by Allah, then we can understand the power of Allah, that there is a controller for the whole universe. Okay?
الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم.
And those people who understand, that is, who take or give thoughts to such things, are such people. يذكرون الله. Those people who understand are such people. يذكرون الله. They will remember Allah. They will remember Allah. Verse is not there. Arabic. Okay. English language. Then, قياماً standing, وقعوداً sitting, وعلى جنوبهم and laying on their sides. That is, in all the states, they will remember Allah. Standing, sitting, and when they are laying on their sides. ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض. And they will brood over. They will give thought to what? في خلق السماوات والأرض. In the creation of the heavens and the earth. ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. And they will say, thinking or giving thoughts, they will say what? They will pray to Allah what? ربنا, our Lord, ما خلقت هذا باطلا. Certainly you have not created all these things aimlessly. Batil, without any intention, without any aim. Certainly there are purpose. There is clear purpose of planning behind all these things. Okay, then Subhanak, and glory to Allah. You are exalted. Faqina adab an-nar, then protect us from an-nar. Hellfire, then the punishment of the hellfire. عذاب النار. Now next verse.
ربنا إنك من تدخل النار فقد أخزيته وما للظالمين من أنصار.
Our Lord, ربنا. إنك certainly you, indeed. من تدخل النار. Whoever you admit to the hellfire. Whomsoever you admit to the hellfire, to Jahannam, then فقد أخزيته. Suddenly you have disgraced him. You have disgraced him. Then وما للظالمين من أنصار. And for the wrongdoers, for the ظالمين, there are no helpers at all. Only Allah can help people. Okay. Then
ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار.
ربنا أو our Lord إننا سمعنا. Certainly we have heard. سمعه heard. مناديا a caller. ينادي calling. Alil Iman, calling to faith, to the faith of Allah, to the Tawheed, to Kalima Tayyiba. Then, An Aminu bi Rabbikum, you call in your Lord. A caller called us to the faith of Allah. That is, you believe in Allah, you believe in your Lord. Fa amanna. Then we believed. That is, we believed in you. We believed in Islam. We believed in Islam. We embraced Islam. Then, ربنا our Lord فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا. So hence you forgive us ذنوبنا our sins. You forgive us our sins. Then وكفر عنا and you remove from us سيئاتنا our vices, our wrong deeds, our misdeeds. Okay. وتوفنا and you make us die مع الأبرار among the or with the righteous people. Abrar, righteous people, good people.
ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد.
ربنا our Lord وآتنا and you grant us ما وعدتنا what you have promised us. Then, what? Ala rusulika, upon your messengers. Wala tukhzina, and you do not disgrace us. Yawm al-qiyamah, on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment. Innaka la tukhliful mi'ad, certainly you will not fail, you do not fail in your promises, in your promise. Next verse.
فاستجاب لهم ربهم أني لا أضيع عمل عامل منكم من ذكر أو أنثى بعضكم من بعض فالذين هاجروا وأخرجوا من ديارهم وأوذوا في سبيلي وأوذوا في سبيلي وقاتلوا وقتلوا لأكفرن عنهم سيئاتهم ولأدخلنهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ثوابا من عند الله والله عنده حسن الثواب لا يغرنك تقلب الذين كفروا في البلاد مطاع قليل ثم مأواهم جهنم وبئس المحاد لكن الذين اتقوا ربهم لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها نزلا من عند الله وما عند الله خير للأبرار وإن من أهل الكتاب لمن يؤمن بالله وما أنزل إليهم خاشعين لله لا يشترون بآيات الله ثمنا قليلا أولئك لهم أجرهم عند ربهم إن الله سريع الحساب يا أيها الذين آمنوا اصبروا وصابروا ورابطوا واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون.
Then, so when the believers, the mu'mineen, offer such a prayer or invoke Allah in such a way, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ, and their Lord replied or responded to them. What? How? أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعُ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ, certainly I will not allow to lose your the deed of any of the worker, the work of any of the worker. عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ, from amongst you. مِّنْكُمْ, from amongst you. مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى, male or female. So if you have worked, I will not make you I will not lose your work. I will not allow to be lost your work. Okay? Then male or female, both will get the reward. Okay? Then بَعْضُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْضُ, and you are of one another. فَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا, and those people who migrated from their land for Allah's sake, you know, hijra. Okay? وَأُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ, and those people who were evicted from their houses because of hijra, you know, hijra from Makkah to Medina. So people or believers, sahaba, they lost their properties, they lost their homes, everything, and they migrated in the cause of Allah to Medina. Then وَأُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ وَأُوذُوا فِي سَبِيلِ, and those who were harmed in my path. So for the cause of Allah, they were harmed, they were attacked by others, by the mushrikeen. وَقَاتَلُوا, and they fought. وَقُتِلُوا, and they were killed. Okay, those who were killed, and those who fought, and those who were killed. Okay, then for the cause of Allah, in the cause of Allah, لَأُكَفِّرَنَّ عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ, certainly I will remove from them their misdeeds or vices, سيئات, وَلَأُدْخِلَنَّهُمْ, and I will enter them, I will enter them, جَنَّاتٍ, to the gardens, to the gardens, جَنَّات, to the heavens, gardens. Okay, تَجْرِي, and that those gardens are تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا, beneath which rivers flow, which is Al-Anhar, Nahur in Jammu, Anhar. Nahur means river, river, Anhar, rivers. So beneath which rivers flow. So I will grant them, I will enter them, what? To the, I will enter them into the gardens beneath which rivers flow. Thawaban min indillah, thawaban min indillah, as a reward from their Lord, Allah. From Allah. Wallah, and Wallahu indahu husnu thawab, and Allah has with him the best reward. The best reward is with Allah alone. Okay. لا يغرنك تقلب الذين كفروا في البلاد. Be not deceived. غرة, غرور, deceiving. غرور. Okay. Be not deceived by the uninhibited or uncontrolled movement of the wrongdoers in the nation, in the land. So sometimes we see the believers, they will be enjoying, they will be living luxuriously, they will have tall buildings, fine houses, every conveniences. Then we should not deceive in such things. Okay, we should not think that they are good, and that's why Allah is giving them, okay, abundantly. They actually, what is that? مَطَاعٌ قَلِيلٌ ثُمَّ مَأْوَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ وَبِئْسَ الْمِهَادُ. مَطَاعٌ قَلِيلٌ, it is but a small enjoyment when compared to the akhirah, to the hereafter. this world's life is very 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 trivial, very very small. Okay, then ثم متاع قليل, it is a very very small enjoyment only. Okay, mama ثم مأواهم جهنم, and wretched is the resting place. بئس المهاد, and their final refuge is hellfire. مأوا means refuge. جهنم hellfire. وبئس المهاد, and very bad or wretched is their resting place. مهاد, مهاد is resting place. So our final resting place should be heavens, heaven. Okay, heaven. So the non-believers or the arrogant people, their resting place heart will be the eternal hellfire. May Allah grant us Jannah. Ameen. Then mihad, you know, resting place. Alam naj'alil adha mihada wal jibala awtada wa khalaqnakum azwaja. There we have seen. Alam naj'al, have we made you what? Al ard, the earth, mihada, as a resting place, as a resting place. So here it is a resting place, it's okay, but it is temporary. This earth is, this dunya, this life is very temporary. Okay, the eternal life is to come after our death. Okay, then
لكن الذين اتقوا ربهم لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها نزلا من عند الله وما عند الله خير للأبرار.
لكن but, لكن in Hindi, Urdu, you see, لكن, لكن, root is from Arabic. Okay, لكن الذين اتقوا, but those who feared their Lord, ربهم, لهم, for them, جنات, there are gardens, تجري من تحتها الأنهار, beneath which rivers flow. Then خالدين فيها, they will abide therein forever. So once we enter Jannah, then we will live there forever. Then no death at all. Okay, they will the believers will abide there forever. So we should work for that in this world. Then only we will get it. Okay. May Allah grant us Jannah. Ameen. Ameen. Then خالدين فيها, they will abide therein forever. نُزْلًا مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, as a hospitality or as a recommendation from their Lord Allah. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِلْأَبْرَارِ, and that which is with Allah is the best for the righteous people. So that which is with Allah in the Akhirah, that is the best for the believers, the best for the righteous people, good people. Okay. Now,
وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَمَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ.
Now, and indeed among the people of the scripture, أَهْلُ Kitab, we know أَهْلُ Kitab, who are أَهْلُ Kitab? Ahlul Tawrat, Ahlul Injil, Ahlul Zabur. That is the previous, the people of the previous generations, or the previous books. The book of Moses, that is
Tawrat.
And the book revealed through Isa alayhi salam, Prophet Jesus alayhi salam, that is Injil. Now the original texts are no more. Okay, only the distorted versions are available. Okay, then.
وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ, and indeed among the people of the scripture are, لَمَنْ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ,
there are from among the people of the scripture, a group of people are there who believe in Allah. Then,
وَمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ,
and who believe to in what was revealed to you, that is, who believe in Holy Quran, that is the final word of Allah or the final message of Allah, that is Holy Quran. They believe in Holy Quran too, because the coming of the prophet was prophesied in the previous scriptures, in their scriptures, the final words or the final kalam of Allah. That is the final edition of the kalam of Allah. The final book, the final revelation, that is Holy Quran. So they will be believing in Allah and in the book that which is revealed to you. Actually, Quran is revealed to the whole world, not to the Arabs alone, but it was revealed first for the Arabs. It is in the Arabic language. Okay, that's it. وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. And they believe in the revelations which were revealed to them. So mu'minin also, Ummat Muhammad also are like that. They believe in Holy Quran and وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. That is, those revelations which were revealed before this. That is Taurat, Injil, Zabur. In all this and in Suhuf, Suhuf Ibrahim, Suhuf Musa, we believe in all these kalams. But the final, actual words of Allah are not there in the scriptures which are in the hands of these people nowadays. Okay? They have changed it. The kalam of Allah unchanged. Till the day of judgment will be Holy Quran only. Or other books are there in the Lawhul Mahfuz, the original text with Allah. But with the people, no original text is available. Only Holy Quran is available as such, without any change. Now we have seen recently in Birmingham University in the UK, we have seen a scripture, a holy book, it is the Quran, the copy of the Quran, the oldest copy. That too was the same. The two is the same. The two is the same copy of the Quran as it is present. So from that we can understand that no change for the Quran at all. No change at all. But for other scriptures it is not the case. There occurred so many changes. But in the Quran, for the Quran, there was no change at all. There is no change at all, and it will not change at all. Okay. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Certainly, we have revealed this Quran, and we will keep it. Okay. Who said? Allah said. Yes. So, from among the people of the scripture, there are some people, a group of people, who believe in their scripture and in the Holy Quran. خَاشِعِينَ لِلَّهِ. And they being humbly submissive to Allah, submitting their will to Allah. لَا يَشْتَرُونَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ ثَمْنًا قَلِيلًا. They will not exchange the verses of Allah for a small price. That is, they will not tell a lie. That is, knowingly that some people from among them hid or hides the truth. That is, they knew actually the Prophet of Allah, the Messenger of Allah, is the Holy Prophet and he is the final Messenger as it is revealed in their verses. Okay. But still, they do not recognize him. Some of the Ahlul Kitab, they do not recognize the Holy Prophet, not unknowingly. Actually, they knew he was the Holy Prophet, he was the final Prophet, and the Quran was the Kalamullah. Okay, but they thought the final prophet, the final messenger of Allah will come from their tribe. That is from Banu Israel. They were expecting like that. But he came from the Arabs. So some of the Ahli Kitab, they couldn't recognize him. Only that much. Actually, they knew the truth. Okay, that we have seen in Surah Al-Baqarah. When we are discussing that. Okay. No. So my uncle here. So a group of people from amongst the Ahl Kitab, they will believe in their scripture and they will believe in the Holy Quran. And they will not exchange the verses of Allah for small price, that is for their worldly benefits. So for such people amongst the Ahl Kitab, people of the scripture, ulaika, such people, lahum ajruhum inda rabbihim, they will have their reward with their Lord, good reward. Inna Allah sari'ul hisab, certainly Allah is swift, speedy in accounting, in accounts.
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اصْبِرُوا وَصَابِرُوا وَرَابِطُوا وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ.
Oh, you believe, have persevere or have patience, then persevere and endure and remain defensive, remain prepared for the defense of Islam and fear Allah, then you may be successful. Well, that much today. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
So now we shall see the sharah, the explanation given in Fathul Bari by Imam Ibn Hajar Al Asqalani for this hadith, Sahih Al Bukhari, hadith number 183. So Ibn Abbas reports this hadith that في أرل الوسادة I laid on the bed في أرل الوسادة, that is horizontally or transversely, and Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and ميمونة رضي الله عنها, Prophet's wife, laid in the same bed lengthwise. Okay, there في أرل and في أرل, أرل and أرل, two reports are there. Now قوله يمسح النوم أي يمسح بيده عينيه من باب إطلاق اسم الحار على المحل. That is يمسح النوم, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم wiped out the sleep, means that is after waking up from the sleep, he wiped out sleep, means he wiped his face with his wiped his eyes with his hands. Okay, عيني يمسح بيده عيني. Okay, then قوله ثم قرأ العشر الآيات أولها إن في خلق أولها إن في خلق السماوات والأرض إلى آخر السورة. That is قوله ثم قرأ العشر الآيات, that is he recited 10 verses of Surah Ali Imran, the last 10 verses of Surah Ali Imran. أولها إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. So starting from that verse till the end of the Surah, so reciting these 10 verses or 11 verses from Surah Ali Imran is recommended, it is mustahab, it is sunnah after waking up from the sleep. So after waking up from the sleep during night time, during night, we say Bismillah alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi an-nushur. Then we shall recite these verses, these 10 or 11 verses from Surah Ali Imran. So qala ibn battal wa man tabi'ahu fihi dalil ala radd man kariha qira'at al-quran ala ghayri taharatin لأنه صلى الله عليه وسلم قرأ هذه الآيات بعد قيامه من النوم قبل أن يتوضأ. Ibn Abatwal says, Ibn Abatwal and those who follow him says that, say that, but فيه دليل, there is proof على رد من كره قراءة القرآن على غير طهارة. Yes, in this hadith there is proof against the view that it is karahat, it is recommended to be avoided to recite Holy Quran when one is in the impure state, that is in hadas, that is in the state of not having budu. It is called hadasul asghar. Okay, because this hadith, the hadith reports that, but here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited the verses of Holy Quran, that is the last 10 verses of Holy Quran, the last 10 verses from Surah Ali Imran, that is he recited the Quranic verses after he woke up from the sleep and before he took wudu. So only after that he took wudu for the salah. So before that, before taking wudu itself, he recited, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited the verses from Holy Quran. So this is proof against those who advocate that it is karahat to recite Holy Quran or Quranic verses in the state of hadas, in the state of impurity. Okay, in the state of not having wudu. But وتعقبه ابن المنير وغيره بأن ذلك مفرغ على أن النوم في حقه ينقض وليس كذلك لأنه قال تنام عيناي ولا ينام قلبي وأما كونه توضأ عقب ذلك فلعله جدد الوضوء أو أحدث بعد ذلك فتوضأ. So but Ibn al-Munir, another scholar, he goes against the view of Ibn al-Battal. Why? He explains that Prophet's wudu would not become void or would not become lost, would not be lost or would not become batul, would not be batul simply because of his sleep. Because in one hadith, Prophet say, Tanamu aynaya, wala yanamu qalbi, my eyes, my two eyes will sleep, but my qalb will not
sleep.
Will not sleep. So from that hadith we can understand that just because of the sleep, Prophet's wudu will not be lost. Okay. So here we can't say, Ibn al-Munir advocates like this. We can't say Prophet recited the verses of Holy Quran in the state of not having wudu. He would have wudu because of the that is sleep, his wudu will not be lost because of this hadith. Okay, the proof is that tanamu aynaya wala yanamu qalbi. Okay, then now, but we see in this hadith, just before salah, that is after reciting the verses of Surah Ali Imran, he took wudu from fishani mu'allaqa, from a water skin which was kept hanging. Okay, from that he took water and took wudu. Okay, then he performed Salatul Layl, night prayer. Okay, so that was because he might have lost his wudu later. So, because of other reason too, wudu may be lost. So, after reciting the verses, he might have lost the wudu. Or it may be simply to renew the wudu. That is tajdeedul wudu. Tajdeedul wudu. Tajdeedul wudu means renewing the wudu. So renewing the wudu for each salah is sunnah. Suppose if we have wudu, if we took wudu for the salah maghrib, then we didn't lose our wudu till Isha prayer. Then we can pray, we can offer Salatul Isha with that wudu itself. Still, if we renew the wudu, it will be better. It is better. It's called Tajdeedul Wudu. Tajdeedul Wudu. That is renewing the wudu. Renewing the ablution. Okay. No. Ibn Hajar say, that is, Prophet's taking wudu, if he lost it, may not necessarily because of his sleep, as his sleep will not make his wudu void or batil. And it is one of his khususiyat, that is speciality. If we sleep, if we fall asleep, then our wudu will be lost. It's sure. But Prophet's wudu will not be lost. It is his speciality because his eyes only sleeping. His qalb is not sleeping. Okay. Now, as the Prophet ﷺ laid in the bed with his wife, there was chances of mulamasat or touch or contact, we say. Mulamasat means touch or contact with the wife. and hence Imam Bukhari might not have intended the losing of wudu just because of sleep. Okay, so the hadith is given under the bab reciting of Holy Quran or Quranic verses in the state of hadas, badal hadas, in the state of not having wudu. So Imam Bukhari might not have intended that Prophet's wudu was lost due to sleep, but he slept with his wife, so he might have come into contact with, or he might have touched his wife, so he might have lost his wudu. So there is such a chance. Okay, no, and hence لعل البخاري يحتج بفعل ابن عباس في حضرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبي عتبرة التجاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع أهله واللمس ينقل بالوضوء. And Bukhari might have intended that laying in the bed with the wife might have caused the loss of the wudu here. Okay. Not because of sleep. Now Ibn Hajar explains that hadas or impure nature here means only hadasul asghar. That is not having wudu. Not having, the state of not having wudu is called a hadasul asghar. It is a type of impurity as far as a mu'min is concerned. Okay. Hadasul asghar. And it is not hadasul akbar. Here it is not meant. Hadas. The heading given is hadas, badal hadas. But here it is hadasul asghar. That is the state of not having wudu. Not hadasul akbar. Hadasul akbar means sometimes, if one is engaged in sexual intercourse with his wife or wife with his husband and wife, then both will be in hadasul akbar. He said hadasul akbar till they free from it by taking a bath. Okay, so before taking the bath, we say they are in the state of hadasul akbar. Okay, so also a woman having menses after the stoppage of bleeding, then she should free from the hadas, from the hadasul akbar, by taking a bath. Also from nifas too, she should free from the hadas after stopping the bleeding by taking a bath. So till taking the bath, we say he or she is in the state of hadasul akbar. Okay, hadasul akbar. So here it is not meant. Hadasul akbar is not meant here because Prophet took wudu only here. So if hadasul akbar was there, then he might have taken a bath, not only wudu. Okay, so mulamasat with the wife here means just simply touching only, or not sexual contact. Okay. No. Imam Ibn Hajar says there is one hadith rawa muslimun min hadith Ibn Umar karahata dhikrillahi ba'da al-hadath lakinnahu ala ghayri shartil musannif. There is one hadith of Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu which states that reciting the dhikr, the remembrance of Allah, the dhikr of Allah in the state of hadas or impure state is karahat. Karahat means recommended to be avoided. Not purely prohibited, but recommended to be avoided. But that hadith is not according to the criterion of the author, Musannif. Now, from Umdatul Qari, another sharah kitab of this Sahih al-Bukhari, we see some of the extracts. Mutabaqat al-hadith lit-tarjumah fi qira'at al-Qur'an ba'd al-hadith. So here Imam Bukhari gives the title qira'at al-Qur'an ba'd al-hadith, that is reciting Qur'an after or in the state of impurity, impure nature, ba'd al-hadith, after having hadith and before taking wudu. Okay. وَهُوَ أَنَّهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ قَرَعَ الْأَشْرَ الْآيَاتِ مِنْ آخِرِ آلِ إِمْرَانِ بَعْدَ قِيَامِهِ مِنْ نَوْمِهِ قَبْلَ وُضُوئِهِ. So here the title is given like this. because he woke up from the sleep and recited the 10 verses of Surah Ali Imran after before taking wudu. That's why the title is given like that. The author of Umdatul Qari says like this. But Ibn Hajar explained it in another way. We have seen it. Okay. Now. قلت كيف يقال هذا ونومه لا ينقض وضوءه. How can we say like this? Because we can't say in he was in a state of hadas. Because sleep will not lost his wudu. Sleep did not make void his wudu. وقال بعضهم الأظهر أن مناسبة الحديث للترجمة من جهة أن مراجعة الأهل في الفراش لا تخلو من الملاصم ملامسة. No. Some people say that here Prophet might have come into contact with his wife, and that may be the cause of the hadas. Okay. Then قلتُ I say. That is the author of Umdat al-Qari say. هذا أبعد من ذلك لأن لا نسلم وجود ذلك على التحقيق ولئن سلمنا ذلك فمراده من الملامسة اللمس باليد أو الجماع. No. The author of Umdat al-Qari do not agree with this view too. Because Prophet, if Prophet had ملامسات or contact with his wife during the laying, okay, then ولئن سلمنا, if we approve that then ذلك فمراده من الملامسة اللمس باليد أو الجماع. That is, then ملامسة is just touching with the hand or the sexual intercourse, that is jima itself. Which one? He say, he asked, then فإن كان الأول, then if it is the first one, that is just touching with the hands, فلا ينقض الوضوء الصلاة, with just touching, wudu will not be lost. Some people, some scholars said like that. With it, just touching the wife or woman, the wudu will not be lost. Then, siyama fi haqhi, especially in the case of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, wa in kana thani, then if it is the second one, that is sexual intercourse with the wife, which is jima, then fayahtaju ila al-iqtisal, then there will be need for ghusl. Ghusl, that is taking bath. Then walam yujad hadha asl fi hadha al-qissa, fi hadhihi al-qissa, in this story we do not see such an incident. So here Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took wudu only, not ghusl, not taking bath. Okay. Then wallahiru أن البخاري ولا هذا الحديث في هذا الباب بناء على ظاهر الحديث. So Imam Bukhari put this hadith under this bab, just taking its superficial meaning only. This is the view of Imam, the author of Umdat al-Qari. Then no, he continues. Here, based on the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tanamu aynaya wa la yanam qalbi, my two eyes will sleep and not my heart, we may come to the conclusion that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam might have renewed his wudu to increase the light, as he said, al wudu nurun ala nur. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al wudu nurun ala nur. Wudu is light upon light, light upon light. So to increase the nur, increase the light, he might have taken the wudu. Okay, it is. وَحِينَ إِذْنْ يَكُونُ تَجْدِيدُ وُضُوئِهِ لِأَجْلِ طَلَبِ زِيَادَةِ النُّورِ, to increase the nur, to increase the light. حَيْثُ قَالْ الْوُضُوءُ نُورٌ عَلَى نُورٌ. Okay, wudu is light upon light. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took wudu just before salah, after reciting the verses of Holy Quran. Okay, so he might have taken the wudu just to renew the wudu and to increase the light. Okay, because he said al wudu nurun ala nur, wudu is light upon light. Now الثاني فيه جواز الالتجاء عند المحرم وإن كان زوجها عندها. From this hadith we see that we may understand that it is permissible for a mahram, one with whom marriage is prohibited, is called mahram. Okay, to lay in the side of the bed of a woman in which she and her husband are lying together. So here Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his wife Maymunah رضي الله عنها were laying in the bed, and in one side of the bed Ibn Abbas الله عنه was also laying. Okay, Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه his mother's sister was mother sister Maymunah رضي الله عنها. Then الثالث في استحباب صلاة الليل وقراءة الآيات المذكورة بعد الانتباه من النوم. So after waking up from sleep, Salatul Layl is Sunnah. Salatul Layl, night prayer, nafil, prayer is Sunnah. وَقِرَاءَةُ الْآيَاتِ الْمَذْكُورَةِ and the said verses. That is, reciting the 10 verses from Surah Ali Imran, starting with إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتِ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Then, الرابع فيه جواز عرق أذن الصغير لأجل التأذيب أو لأجل المحبة. That is, here catching the ears of children is permissible to educate them, to teach them adab, or to express love towards them. Simply. Okay. الخامس فيه استحباب مجيء المؤذن إلى الإمام وإعلامه بإقامة الصلاة. It is sunnah for the muadhin, one who calls, adhan is called muadhin, to come near imam and to inform him about the time of prayer. So it is sunnah. السادس في تخفيف الركعتين اللتين قبل صلاة الصبح مع مراءة أدائها وغير ذلك من الأحكام التي مضى ذكر بعضها وسيأتي بعضها أيضا في كتاب الوتر إن شاء الله تعالى. It is sunnah to offer two rak'ah of salah before صلاة الفجر. That's also sunnah. So from this hadith we can get these two points. All these points. Now another points are also there. It will be discussed later, inshallah, in Kitab al-Fitr, he said. Okay. Now from Irshad al-Sari, another sharah kitab, you see. ثم ذهبت فقمت إلى جنبي. Then I went and I stood near his side. That is Jambul Aysar. He stood in the left side. So, the adab or as a rule, if only one imam and only one ma'moom is there, then the ma'moom should stood in the
left side.
In the left side.
Right side.
The Ibn Abbas stood in the left side. But as a rule, it should be in
right
the
side.
Right side. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam caught his ears like this and made him stand in the right side. Okay. Yes. So this is for what? Tambihan anil ghafila. غفلت أسردا تا أسردا أول مكان تا صدقهم عن أدب الإتمام وهو القيام على يمين الإمام إذا كان الإمام وحده أو تأنيسا له لكون ذلك كان then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم performed a total of 12 ركع. How many ركع? 12 ركع as 2 multiplied by 5. He offered night prayer. How? Rakataini, Summarakataini, 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 Summarakataini. So, 6 into 2, 12 rak'ah. Then, Autara. So, Al-Majmur is 12, wa huwa yaqayyidu al-mutlaq fi qawlihi babu takhfif, fa salla, mashallah. Then, so, 12. So, in another bab, in another hadith, salla, mashallah. He performed salah as Allah wished. So rak'ah was not mentioned there. The number of rak'ah. Here, the number of rak'ah is given. That is 12 rak'ah. Thumma awtara. Then he performed witr. Witr. Bi wahidatin aw bi thalathin. Bi wahidatin aw bi thalathin. Wa fihi bahthun yati insha'Allah ta'ala. So he performed Salah till Witr one rak'ah or three rak'ah. There is khilaf. There are discussions among the scholars. So that will be discussed later, inshallah. No. If you ask what is the suitability of the title of the bab in which the hadith comes. So, the suitability of the hadith. That is, here this hadith is given under the bab. Bab Qiraat al-Qur'an Ba'd al-Hadath. After the hadith. Or in the state of hadith. Reciting Qur'an in the state of hadith. In the state of not having wudu. How it will be suitable to put this hadith in under this bab. Then, the reply is that there might have been chances of contact or mulamasat with the wife of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But this view is opposed by some because we see in one hadith, كَانَ يُقَبِّلُ بَعْضُ أَزْوَاجِهِ ثُمَّ يُصَلَّى وَلَا يَتَوَضَّأُ. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to kiss his wives and then without taking wudu, he performed salah. So, no, Imam Nawawi records, this hadith is recorded by Nasa'i and Abu Dawud. But Al-Ustad Imam Nawawi rahmatullahi alayhi says that simple touching of women itself will make the wudu void or batil. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.